So this is where I left off last time, and now I just have to load the background, which we saved, and just a quick load, and we can continue to work. And after a little, looking at this hip area, I decided to tweak it just a little bit more. And kind of add a little bit more of a rear behind or jack. And kind of give it a bit more, of contours. Well, nothing big, but I thought it makes all the difference. Kind of give it a bit more of a curve. Now the next thing I won't be creating is making the shoes. So just hiding the geometry that we don't need, make things easier for us, and using the pen tool, I'm just going to start creating the basic shape. As you can see here, I have this reference image on the right side, just to get a sort of idea what kind of shoes we want him to have. So kind of starting from the sole of the shoe and building up. And basically using ruling and I mean bevel, I'm just kind of building the sole of the shoe, and the upper part. And you can see here what we have so far. Now we have this huge polygon down there that I want to take care of right now. So I just tripled everything, I mean this polygon, and then just merged like that, and just added this edge loop in the middle, and now we have only 4-point polygons there. And just kind of building that shape of the shoe from the side view. And just kind of close that up. And right now we cannot use mirror mode. But what I'm going to do is just put all the points in the same value on the x-axis. And let's kind of delete the left half. And center it on the x-axis so we can use the mirror. And yeah, making sure all of those points have zero, these middle points on the x-axis, so we can use symmetry and mirror very efficiently. And closing up this finger area right here. And we can see the shoe is starting to take shape a little bit. And just kind of tweaking it in the right view. So we can see very quickly we're starting to get some results. Of course, we don't have to go into too much detail regarding the shoe. It's as we can see in the reference images, it's just a basic black shoe. And now this moment right here, it's kind of you have to define this this edge loop here, which is kind of the point where the shoe changes direction and starts to create that opening for the foot. And that's always a little bit tricky. Still, we want to be mindful of how everything looks in regards the rest of the model. Is it small enough, big enough, or what's happening there? And now that we're happy with the size, I'm going to start to create this space for the foot. And it's just kind of figuring out how we're going to connect these two parts of the shoe. But of course, symmetry mode does have its limitations in modeler right now. It doesn't take into account the welding of the points. It's just going to weld all the points together, not really taking into account that you want to weld 2 points on the right side and 2 points on the other side. So, you are going to have to jump from symmetry mode and out of it when you want to use the weld tool. So just be mindful of that. And now I'm just kind of seeing if this edge flow is going to work. This transition from this kind of a tube, to the foot area, to the place where the leg comes in, it's always, a bit tricky. But right now everything is, really low poly, so we can easily play with the edge loops and we can easily, adjust things. And that's how I like to keep it. So right now I'm just kind of thinking about how to approach this area in the best way. And as I said, it's nothing's pre-planned. I'm just, you're watching as I'm, dealing with these issues, these topology issues. So sometimes I'll create something and, it won't work, or I won't be happy with with the results I'm getting. And, don't be afraid to just delete it and go back. Because right now, this is what I'm getting. I like a lot more. And of course, one thing you can do is just take a shoe. You'd be surprised how little we know of these common objects that we see every day. Like if you try to draw a bicycle, there was one study done with the people. A bicycle, everybody knows how it looks. But once you try to draw it on a piece of paper without looking at actually a bicycle, just from your memory, people started to draw weird things like Where do you connect the seat? Where do you connect the wheels? And how does it look? And, so it's the same thing with the shoe. You know, I kind of think it's something you really know how it looks. But you should definitely, you know, take a shoe and look at it from different angles and see, you know, really how it looks. And then you will see, you will start to notice these little things, you know, like the shoe is not actually symmetrical in the middle. It kind of follows the shape of the foot, a little bit curving either to the left or to the right, depending on whether is it a left or a right shoe. So that's exactly what I did, you know, just kind of took a shoe and, you know, put it on my table as I modeled this and just kind of looked at it, and you get a much better idea of where you need to go. Of course, for us it's a bit simpler. We're not actually, you know, just modeling a high poly shoe for a shoe commercial. It's supposed to be a little bit more artistic and a little bit, you know, like a puppet shoe. We don't need the stitches and things like that. But what we do need is a good shoe silhouette. And this is what we should be mindful of the most. Because right now, in our case, the shoe is just like a, you know, it's going to mostly be a silhouette. So for this, we need a good shoe shape. And right now, I'm just breaking up that symmetry, you know, trying to create that curve that I talked about. So just tweaking a little bit here and a little bit there already. Now we're starting to get better results. And of course, we should always be mindful of, you know, how close whatever it is we're modeling is going to be in our scene at the end. I don't want to, you know, go too much into stuff which really are never going to be visible. It's a good practice, but now you should be mindful of how much time you spend on different things. It's a good practice. I mean, if you're just doing something for your own pleasure, you don't always, you know, go a bit more into those things. But as you're working on projects, you always have deadlines, and it's best to have this habit of optimizing your workflow. And spending more time on parts which need more attention, which are going to be more visible, rather than, you know, waste your spend your time, I should say, on things which you know, are just not going to be visible. Yeah, so right now I'm pretty happy how it's looking. You know, it's coming along. Just a matter of a few more tweaks. I'm kind of making those edges a bit more sharper. It's going from sub-patch mode to polygon mode to see how it's going to sub-patch. If I need to add some extra subdivisions, you know, to make it a bit sharper. And select loop is a really nice thing. also, you know, just gives us the ability to select loops much quicker. And right now I'm just thinking about this bottom part of the shoe, whether I want it to stick out a bit more or less, you know. It's these, you know, small things that sometimes, you know, can give a different character to the shoe. And right now it's kind of too flat, so I just want to curve it a little bit more, you know. Usually in these shoes, you have the finger part going up a little bit more. And I want to kind of give it a bit of a heel. And yeah, it's looking pretty good. I just want to add, you know, some thickness. So this area here. Well, basically, you never want to have like this one polygon thickness to you know, whatever it is that you're doing. You always wanted to have some thickness, because in the real world nothing is one polygon thick. So you know, you'll never go wrong if you give something thickness when you're creating it. I'm just kind of looking at it, you know, in regards to his feet. You know, what you want to have, although we won't make a actual foot, you want it to give this, you know, feeling that the foot is actually inside, that it's fitting. So it's just kind of, you know, stretching it or not, you know, are you happy with the size? And of course, you can always resize it later on if you feel the need. You know, once the whole object is finished, you might, you know, get a better idea of how you want it to look. And just adding a new surface to the shoe. This also helps us, you know, to select different parts of the model very quickly. You know, just using a select surface. And now that the shoe is there, I'm just adding the area where the knees are going to be. And kind of breaking up this perfect tube feeling a little bit, you know, just to kind of add it and be more of a textural moment, where the shoe meets the pants. And of course, adding one more subdivision just so we can control how, you know, it affects all the way this area all the way to the knee. And now you're just kind of designing, you know, you want to stay true to the model that already exists. I mean, the Jack's, you know, actual figure. But also you want to have a little bit of your own imprint. So whether you want to make these pants, you know, like just like a tube, or add a bit more character, is basically for you. And yeah, pretty happy with the shoes. And this is also a perfect area just to save our work, save what we've done so far. And a nice spot to end this session. And all our Jack needs is a pair of hands and a couple of tweaks. And that's what we're going to tackle in the next couple of sessions.